something big. Nice fish. Maybe about 3 pounds. Nice. 17 inches. Little striper. A little striper. there. Doesn't take long. So this is what they're eating. Just very small little shad. This thing's maybe an inch and a half long and they're just chewing it up. Big perch right there. Pretty good size. If I had to guess, I'd say that weighed about 15 pounds maybe. I'm going to talk a little bit about what I'm doing here. I came out late. I was on a backpacking trip the last couple days, so I was a little tired this morning, and came out about 10:30. Came out to an area that I fish sometimes in the fall. The fish seem to school up here pretty well in the fall. I'm sitting in about 40 to 50 feet of water, so I'm well offshore. There's really no structure to speak of. There's a couple points that come out into the lake, but I'm thinking it's a calm, it's a pretty warm day. It's maybe in the low 70s already. And I'm just sitting out here. I saw a few fish rising up and splashing on bait, which I expected. So started fishing some top water. Most of those fish seem to be fairly small, little schooling bass. And so I dropped down a spoon down into 30, 45 feet of water and, you know, started picking up a lot of perch and some pretty nice bass. I'm thinking what happens is on these warm temperature, calm days, that upper water warms up pretty well and the shad sort of ease up towards the surface. And then the bass start schooling up and pushing them up. So certainly well offshore, probably, I don't know, you can see over there is about as close as I've been to shore, so I'm not really fishing any particular cover. I'm just watching my electronics and looking for schools. It's starting to look like they're dispersing a little bit now. Maybe the feeding's starting to slow down. I'm seeing fewer fish hit the surface and, you know, not marking as many. So they've either moved to a new location or really stopped feeding. But certainly some pretty good action when you get into it. I know a lot of the magazines, they tell you to throw a jig at a dock all day, but if you've never tried offshore fishing, you gotta learn how to do it. It's somewhat of an art. It's not quite as straightforward as fishing the banks, but if you kind of fish some of these covers or these open waters with some points and different things, there is a lot of fish out here, so it's really something worth trying when you're not doing well elsewhere. Or, you know, maybe in each day you spend an hour just learning the deeper offshore stuff. So anyway, I'm going to get back and try and figure out what's going on next. So keep watching. fly rod bass. Well, that's a big bass right there. That's huge.
Can you go? Thank you.